This problem, we want to evaluate the partial derivative of Gibbsy energy with respect to pressure. And we want to do this partial derivative of constant temperature. And we want to end up with something that's in terms of variables we can measure. And so we'll start with the definition of Gibbsy energy. Gibbsy energy just H minus TS. And now if we take and just directly apply it to this, the partial G respect to pressure at constant temperature becomes the partial of H respect to pressure at constant temperature. Since temperature constant, we can write it partial of S respect to pressure at constant temperature. So no, we didn't have temperature just all outside the derivative because it was a constant for this calculation. Now we want to simplify this to write it in terms of other variables, because we want in terms of measurable variables. And so we're going to use one of the Maxwell relations. And this one is the partial of S respect to pressure at constant temperature is equal to partial of volume respect to temperature at constant pressure. So this is one of the standard Maxwell relationships. The other we have to determine again, something that was derived elsewhere, and we can talk about where this came from, but let's write it down first. So you can see we now have these two terms. These are in terms of measurable variables, so we're essentially finished if we can determine where this second equation came from. So let's go back and look at the differential expression for the first law for closed system. And if we do this reversibly, dq is tds, and dw is minus pdv. And now, since h is u plus pv, dh is du plus pdv plus vdp. So dh is, du is here, tds minus pdv plus PdV plus VdP. So these cancel, and so we have the differential of H in terms of entropy and pressure. So we're partway there. We want the partial of H respect to P at constant T. So what we're going to do is apply the expansion rule to this. And the expansion rule says I can take this derivative, differential, and I can write it like so. So this sort of looks like we divided the both sides by dp, made them all partial derivatives, and then t constants. Actually more complicated than that, but that's certainly an easy way to remember it, and you can check textbook for more detailed explanation. But the expansion rule gives us this, which we can simplify: t ds dp constant t plus v times 1, the partial p respect to p is 1. And now notice this partial of s respect to p, we have this Maxwell relation, so we can substitute the Maxwell relation here. Now I've made the substitution, now I have this partial of h respect to p. This is the equation that I wrote down up here. So essentially now I can substitute this equation and this equation into this equation, and I'll be finished. So I've just made the substitution of those two equations into our original equation, and we can see this term and this term are going to cancel, and we end up with the Gibbsy energy changes with pressure at constant temperature is equal to the volume. And with many of these types of calculations, knowing how to get the answer already makes it much easier to do the calculations, because we have to go in, use Maxwell relations, have to go back and go to some of our original definitions, and then here using the expansion rule. So they're not always obvious, the approach to get to our final answer.